गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर 10th चैप्टर एंड न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज रेस्पिरेशन इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म। ओके, सो चिल्ड्रन, रेस्पिरेशन ऑकर इन ऑल ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड इन दिस प्रोसेस ऑक्सीजन इज टेकन इन एंड वाइल कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड वाटर वेपर्स आर रिलीज्ड। सी, दिस इज द रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग। सो वी इनहेल एंड एक्सहेल थ्रू अवर नोज। The nasal cavity is divided into nasal chambers by a partition, okay? And each nasal chamber opens to the outside by a nostril. So nasal chamber have nasal hairs and mucus also. So oxygen carrying air, what we are inhaling, reaches the trachea via the nasal chambers. You can see in this picture. Then the trachea bifurcates into two parts called bronchi. Okay, lungs are present in a cavity called the pleural cavity, and it is like a honeycomb. Small cavities are present in that. So many similar cavities called alveoli, you can see in this picture, are found on the inner walls of the lungs. The end of the bronchi open into these alveoli. So at the bottom of the pleural cavity is a muscular partition called the diaphragm. You can see clearly all these things in the picture. So this is all about the respiratory system of human beings. You might have understood from the above explanation that we breathe in, inhale, and the chest moves upward and the diaphragm moves downward, and this causes the lungs to expand. So air pressure in the lungs decreases and oxygen rich air comes into the lungs, and this is only called inhalation. So during breathing out or exhalation, the chest moves downward and the diaphragm moves upward. Air pressure in the lungs increases and the lungs contract. So as a result of this, carbon dioxide air filled in the lungs and goes out through the nostrils. This process is only called inhalation and exhalation. Together it is called breathing. Now we will see respiration in other organism. Like human beings, cows and buffaloes, other organisms do respire. This is the diagram of fish. Fishes respire with the help of gills. So gills can be seen inside the flaps. They are the respiratory organs of fish. Water taken in through the mouth passes over the gills, and the oxygen present in the water dissolves through the blood and it starts circulating in the gill. Carbon dioxide is released into the outgoing water. So insects like butterfly, cockroach, mosquitoes, etc. have a network of respiratory pipes inside their trachea. Now the next topic is respiration in plants. Like animals, plants also take oxygen from the atmosphere and releases carbon dioxide. The surface of leaves bear innumerable small pores and they are called stomata. Generally, the lower surface of the leaf has more stomata as compared to the upper surface. Exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide takes place to the stomata, and water vapor also goes out through the leaves to the stomata. So stomata are the small pores through which exchange of gases takes place. So here, student, we are ending our today's chapter. Question answers tomorrow you will get in the WhatsApp link or in the assignment section. Thank you.